Hi friends, today we are going to make part 5. Okay, we are going to do part 5 of our case study series. Okay, so the first question is, first case study today is the International Bank provides following data regarding rate sensitive assets and liabilities of the bank. The nil spread in percentage is 2%. Okay, this thing you don't not to worry about now. And this data they have given as on 31st March 2010. Assets and liabilities data of International Bank is given in our question. Okay, and this table we already understood. In part 4 we have done some questions like this. Okay, so we already understood the type of time of bucket, different time buckets are there. These are sensitive, these are non-sensitive assets data they have given, and total. Okay, this is assets, this is liability. How do we calculate gap? Gap is assets minus liability. Okay, 2100 minus 2400 is equal to minus 300. Like this, they have calculated this gap column. And cumulative gap, I already told you, minus 300 we will take like this, 200. But this thing is also given, so you need not to worry about cumulative gap, okay, or gap they are providing you here in the table itself. So the first question is, if the interest rates falls by 30 basis point, okay, if the interest rate falls by 30 basis point in the time bucket 3 to 6 months, so they are asking this bucket only, na? So we will ignore other buckets and we will see only 3 to 6 month time buckets. Assets is 3100, liabilities 3700, so our gap is minus 600. Okay, so the likely impact on the net interest income for the bank is, okay, NII. This is NII. NII means net interest income, net interest net interest income. See, so 30 basis point, we already know that 100 basis point is equal to 1%. 100 basis point is equal to 1%. That means 30 basis point will be 1 into 30 divided by 100%. Divided by 100%, percent will come here now. So what value will come? 0.30%, 0.30%. okay, that's why they have taken this interest rate percentages 0.30%. okay, it is falling down. Okay, so they are asking for this time bucket. See, 600, gap is negative, it means bank is having more liabilities compared to assets. That I have already mentioned you in the part 4, na? This type of question we have already done. When gap is negative, it means, how we calculate gap? Gap means assets minus liabilities. Gap means assets minus liabilities. If gap is coming negative, it means our liabilities are more compared to our assets. Okay, if liabilities are more and interest rate is falling down, what will happen? Then bank has to pay less. Bank can save some money. Instead of paying for its liabilities, that money can be saved. Okay, why that money, how that money can be saved? Because interest rate has come down, it has fallen down by 30 basis point. 30 basis point means 0.30% interest has come down, and bank is not going to pay this money to its liability customer. Okay, he's not going to pay it because it got saved. And how it got saved? Because interest rate has fallen down. Okay, so how much was the gap? Gap was 600. So 600 multiply by 0.30% is equal to 1.80 crore. Okay, so this is net interest income. Why net interest income? Because net we calculate. Okay, net we calculate. How we calculate net? By taking assets minus liability difference, gap. And if we multiply our gap with the interest rate, whatever it is falling or increasing, we can get our net interest income. What is the impact on our NII, net interest income? So it will come 1.80 crore. Okay, so plus sign will come. Why plus sign? Because it is a gain for the bank. Okay, in terms of RBI guidelines on ALM, the maximum rate sensitive assets, and there is no restrictions by RBI. okay, whatever the amount, whatever the percentage it can be. Okay, so the bank have to percent to its total asset. There is no such restrictions put by RBI. The total rate sensitive assets of the bank is, how we calculate? Out of total assets, if we subtract our non-sensitive assets, this is asset table our, na? This is asset column. So out of total assets, if we calculate our non-sensitive asset, we will get rate sensitive asset. So 11,600 minus 800, it will come 10,800. Okay, here it is mistake, printing mistake. So it is 11,600. So it will come 10,800. Option number D is the correct answer. In the declining interest scenario, okay, the bank will have a, okay, this type of question we have already done. Okay, net interest income. What will have? See, total rate sensitive asset is 10,800. How we have calculated 11,600 minus 800? It will come 10,800. Okay, and rate sensitive liability, how we have calculated 11,600 minus 1,000? It will come 10,600. Okay, bank is asset sensitive. Okay, so bank is having more asset. That is why it is having a more. Bank is having more asset sensitive. Value, that is why it is asset sensitive. In asset sensitive scenario, in the rising scenario, in asset sensitive case, in the rising scenario, bank will gain, and in declining scenario, bank will lose. Okay, this type of question we have already done, so this is a kind of practice. Okay, we can easily understand that this type of question, if they ask if it is asset sensitive and in rising scenario the bank will gain, or in declining scenario the bank will lose. If the question is just opposite, if it is a liability sensitive, here instead of 10,600, if it is 11,000, then this case would be liability sensitive. Why? Because 10,800 is less than 11,000. The example that we are just taking, so bank is liability sensitive in that case. And what will happen in that case? This is just opposite. In the rising scenario, bank will lose, or in gaining scenario, declining scenario, bank will gain. Okay. So whenever bank is asset sensitive, so in a rising scenario, bank will gain, or declining scenario, bank will lose. Okay, for asset sensitive you remember, for liability sensitive just opposite means in case of rising bank will lose, in case of declining bank will gain. Okay, next. So this is our case study 2, part 5. See, international bank has the following repricing assets and liabilities. I told you now, interest rate is coming down or it is increasing, so bank has to reprice its assets and liabilities. So that thing they are telling, see, call money, cash credit, cash in hand, saving bank, FD and current deposit, some amount they have given, like call money 300, cash in hand 200 crore, every data in crores. So based on the above information, answer the question. First, what is the adjusted gap in repricing assets and liabilities? How you have to calculate adjusted gap? Adjusted gap means assets minus liabilities. Gap is assets minus liabilities, okay? Gap means assets minus liabilities, that I have already done. Gap means G for gap. Gap means assets minus liabilities. So they have used one word before, gap. What is that word? That is adjusted. It got adjusted. Why it got adjusted? Because it got repriced. The price has changed. Because of why price has changed? Because market in the market interest rate is coming down or increasing. Because of that, price has changed. Okay. And because of change in price, the gap has adjusted. It is changing. That's why they have used the word adjusted gap. Okay, because repricing, price is changing for assets and liabilities. So we have to calculate adjusted gap. Formula will be same, assets minus liabilities. You tell me how much assets you are having. I already defined you here. Directly they have not given, like assets, liabilities. In the column form they have not given, like they have provided in case study one. But we can calculate what is our assets and what is our liabilities. See, so call money and cash credit. Call money and cash credit. First to take, see, cash in hand, it has nothing to do with interest rate. Okay, interest rate it won't affect, because you are having cash at your hand. So in the market, if interest rate is coming down or increasing, you don't have to do anything. So this data you just ignore. Okay, next, current deposit. In current deposit you are not getting any interest, bank is not paying you any interest, so this thing also not to do anything. So these two things you have to ignore. Okay, so remaining thing, saving bank and fixed deposit. So that is liability for the bank. Liability is saving bank or FD. Saving bank or FD is liability for the bank. Why? Because bank is paying interest to this customer in these two. Saving bank will give you interest like 4%. In FD, bank will provide you interest like 7%, 7.5 or 7.8, whatever the percentage. Okay. So saving bank, FD, liabilities. What is the amount they have given for saving bank? 300 crore. FD. How much? FD or fixed deposit. FD means fixed deposit, 300 crore. Saving bank also 300. Okay. So both 300. Sum of these two. Because total liability we have to calculate now. So sum of 300 plus 300, how much it will come? 600. 600 crore. So liabilities we have calculated. Now we have to calculate assets. Okay. So asset. Asset is the bank. Bank asset is a type of loan. Okay, the loan that bank has given, and he will get some interest. He will earn some money. That is asset for the bank. Okay, so in one line, if I have to define asset and liability, if you have to remember, so you just, if bank is paying interest, that is liability. okay, if bank is getting some interest, that is asset for the bank. Okay, you can remember by this term. If bank money is going in terms of interest, that is liability. If bank is getting some money in terms of interest, it is asset. Okay, so in cash credit loans, cash credit CC loan, a type of overdraft loan, bank is getting some interest. So 240 crore, this is cash credit, is asset for the bank. And same call money, in call money also bank are giving money to other bank also, for 1 day, 15 days, different call money for 1 day only, but bank is getting some interest also for 1 day. So it is 300 crore. So 300 plus 240, call money or cash credit, both are asset for the bank. So how much? 540 will come. So asset is 540, liabilities are 600. What is the formula? Asset minus liability. 540 minus 600, how much it will come? Minus 60. 540, okay, one second. 540 minus 600. Fine, 60 will come, correct. 540 minus 600, how much it will come? Minus 60. Okay, minus 60, negative gap. Option number C. Okay, so adjusted gap is minus C. See, they have mentioned minus 60, assets are less than liabilities, hence a negative gap. Okay, or liabilities are more than assets, you can say. Cash in, see, they have mentioned here also. The cash in bank and current account are not subject to repricing. Why? We can't change their price now. We can't change their interest. Because we are not getting an interest, then how can we reprice them? As they are not interest-bearing. Interest bearing, we are not getting interest, hence this have not, this have to be ignored. Okay, this thing we have to be, this thing need to be ignored. Okay, so 60 negative gap. Next, what is the change in net interest income? What is the change in net interest income if interest falls by 2.2% points across the board for all the assets and liabilities? What is change in net interest income? NII it is asking, okay, NII, net interest income. We have already calculated, it is negative 60, okay, negative 60. So that 60, our gap was coming, now. So see, 60 gap was coming means negative 60. It means our liabilities are more. Liabilities are more. And if interest rate is falling down, if interest rate is falling down, then this is good for bank, or if interest rate is falling down, it means it is good for bank. Why? Because it has to pay less to its higher liabilities. It is having more liabilities now. So it has to pay less 2% on its 60 liabilities. That on its 60, 60 is our gap now. So 60 gap multiplied by the percentage declining 2%. So 1.20 crore. So it will improve. NII will improve. Why improve? Because bank can save some money now. So net interest income is their income can be saved. It can be improved. Saved, another word for saved is improved here. Why it got saved? Because in the market interest rate is coming down and bank is having more liabilities compared to assets. It means more money it has to give to more people, more liabilities it is having compared to assets. So interest rate is falling down, bank will get less interest on its assets, as well as it will get less, so it will pay less for its liabilities. But as bank is having more liabilities, so it will be in gain. Okay, it is a gain for the bank. So it improved by, so in the what will happen to NII, it will improve by 1.20 crore. Next, if it is increasing by 1.2%, see, if the interest rate on assets and liability increase by 2%, it is increasing. So what is change in net interest income? In this case it will decline. Okay, why? They have a, which means the interest, see, why it is a net interest income will decline. Minus 60 we have calculated already in the first question of this case study. Okay, it means our minus 60, our adjusted gap, it means our negative sign has come. Why it has come? Because our liabilities are more compared to our assets. If liabilities are more, it means bank has more liabilities to pay compared to its asset. Okay, but now in the market interest rate is increasing, so bank has to pay more. It will get, interest rate is increasing, it will get a increase in income from its assets. As same time, it has to give to its customer as liabilities, but more liabilities are there, so it is a loss for the bank. Okay, more liabilities, so it is a loss for the bank, because more people it has to pay. It will save some money also, because assets also it is having, but not that much. Liabilities are more compared to assets, that's why its loss will be more compared to its gain. Okay, how much that loss? First we calculate that gap, that is 60 into 2%, 1.20 crore loss it will be. So NII will decline to this. So decline by 1.20 crore. Next. See, now different for every thing they have told, like all call money 1% interest fall, cash credit one, saving bank this, and FD this percent. What is the change in net interest income? See, call money how much? 1%. So call money what amount? 300. 1% we calculate, it will come 3 crore. Cash credit 240. How much cash? 240, and cash credit 0.60. It is falling. Okay, so how much total amount? 3 plus 1.4 or 4.4 crore. Okay, so net fall is this. Same, we calculate fall in liabilities. For assets we have calculated saving bank and FD is liabilities for the bank. Okay, saving bank what amount? 300, and FD also 300. Saving bank 0.20% and FD 1%. We just calculate. So net fall here is this 3.0 plus 0.6. So how much it will come? 3.60. 3 crore plus 0.6, it will come 3.6 crore. Okay, so net interest income, what is the change in net interest income? Same, assets minus liabilities, net interest income is gap, NII gap. Okay, so asset minus 4.40 minus 3.6, it will come 0.84 crore. okay, 0.84 it will decline by, because it is falling now, everything is falling, so it will also fall by what amount? Just we have to subtract. Next question, it is the same questions, just we have done now, but instead of falling it is increasing. Same thing we have to calculate, 1%, 0.5, 0.0, 1.8. okay, call money 0.5%, call money what is the amount? 300, 0.5%. how much? 1.50. cash credit 1%, cash credit 240 crore they have given. 1% we will calculate, it will come 2.40. to total 1.50 plus 2.40, it will come 3.90. same we will calculate for liabilities also. Okay, assets is our call money and cash credit, liabilities are fixed deposit and saving bank. Okay, so that also we will calculate. What will come? It will come like this, total sum is this. So assets minus liabilities, 3.90 minus 2.7, as it is increasing, so it will improve by 1.20, improve by 1.20, declining by now, so 1.20. printing mistake, so it will be this. Okay, net improvement, if it is increasing it will improve by that percent. Okay, with this it is the end of our slide, and the next part 6 I will provide you within 1 or 2 days. You practice for this video. Okay, and thank you very much for watching this video.